Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to PWE. To start off the night, we have singles action. And here comes the number one contender for the International Championship, the Best Bout Machine, Kenny Omega.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from Winnipeg, Manitoba, Canada, weighing in at 218 pounds, Kenny Omega!
Kenny Omega has a date with this. Kenny Omega has a date with the man named, again, this legendary man of PWE. Last episode, he snapped. It's Tyler Drake. It will be Tyler Drake versus Kenny Omega. Had opportunity for it all in a singles match, because the last time they fought was the last man standing match for the PWE Championship match. And Kenny Omega said that he thinks that Tyler Drake cannot beat him in singles competition. To which made Tyler Drake respond by saying, "Don't talk to me about singles competition when you put yourself up as a world champion in your own
weighing in at 206 pounds, Daniel Garcia.
A lot of heat between Kenny Omega and Tyler Drake, already ahead of opportunity for it all. And now, Tyler Drake has got to be watching this match very closely. You see what he did to Jeff Hardy last week. Can he do that to Daniel Garcia here tonight? Can Kenny Omega do that to Daniel Garcia tonight? Who knows? Here we go. Oh, nice knee to the face. And now stomping all over Daniel Garcia. Oh, and stomp to the midsection right on the gut of Garcia. Oh, and slams him down. And now just choking him out. And now Daniel Garcia has no idea what to do. Oh, wait a minute, Garcia counters. Daniel Garcia with the counter. This is the last episode before PWE, opportunity for it all. But we have a six-man ladder match, and there are only four participants announced. And oh my God, right on the apron. Kenny Omega is a savage. But we only have four participants announced, and there will be two mystery opponents. Oh no. Nice knee. Two. Daniel Garcia. Oh, and a counter from Garcia. And these two men going at it. And Daniel Garcia sends Kenny Omega back inside of the ring. And now, Daniel Garcia back in the ring himself. And Kenny Omega meets him. And now, looking for Fisherman Brainbuster. Fisherman Brainbuster. And now a Uranagi. And here goes Kenny Omega with a 450 splash. I've never seen that from Kenny Omega before. Kenny Omega must want this badly. And look at this. And the moves from Daniel Garcia. Oh, and a brainbuster. Daniel Garcia trying to fight back. Oh, and look at that. Daniel Garcia. Oh, and look at this. Kenny Omega suplex right on the knee. And Kenny Omega's going for it. One minute angel. Cover on Garcia. It's over. Kenny Omega wins here tonight.
Here is your winner, Kenny Omega.
Listen, Tyler. We want to talk about my friends. We want to talk about how I became an EVP of AEW and put myself over in a company. You want to get mad? You want to cuss in front of all these fans, in front of all these children? I'm not going to do that. I'm in your head. You're afraid of me, Tyler. You are afraid. You are afraid, and you know that the end of your International Championship reign is coming to an end simply by the hands of Kenny Omega. And I don't need Don Callis. I don't need the Young Bucks. I don't need anybody. I don't need Hangman Adam Page. I certainly don't need Kota Ibushi. I don't need anybody but myself in order to beat you, and that's no disrespect to those guys. I will see you at Opportunity for It All. Wow, Kenny Omega says that Tyler Drake is afraid, that he is scared. We will see how scared Tyler Drake is at Opportunity for It All. Our next match, MJF going up against the number one contender for the television title, Keith Lee. Another match on the card, but we will not see the competitors tonight, is Rey Fénix and Penta El Zelo Medo, the Lucha Brothers, going up against the Hardy Boys for the PWE World Tag Team Champions. The Lucha Bros trying to retain those titles. They just beat both Hardys in one-on-one singles competition. Fénix beat Matt Hardy, and Penta beat Jeff due to some controversy. But here comes the salt of the earth right now.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from Long Island, New York, weighing in at 226 pounds, MJF.
MJF here tonight to try to take down Keith Lee before his big match with Andre Graves at Opportunity for It All. Can he do it? We are going to find out. Here tonight, Keith Lee has a statement to make. But he has to make it. He's one of the most hardest hitting young athletes in professional wrestling known as MJF. Comes the Limitless. It's time to bask in his glory here.
And his opponent from Wichita Falls, Texas, weighing in at 340 pounds, Keith Lee.
Keith Lee here tonight, looking to make a statement ahead of his match with Andre Graves, who isn't here tonight. He will be an Opportunity for It All, defending the television championship. Keith Lee is looking to send a statement to Andre Graves. Andre Graves and Keith Lee have a mutual respect for each other, as you've seen last episode in Andre Graves' post-match promo. But there is Keith Lee. Let's see what Keith Lee has to say about it. If we can win this match right now. There is MJF. There is Keith Lee. And these two are going to start off. And MJF has a hold of Keith Lee, but Keith Lee with the elbows to the gut, getting out of that predicament. And Keith Lee missed the chop, but hit him with another chop and chops the shoulders. And look at the size advantage Keith Lee has here in that. Oh, and a big belly-to-belly suplex, throwing MJF over his body like he is nothing. You see the muscles on MJF. You know that he is very strong. But here's Keith Lee. Keith Lee, nice punch. And Keith Lee What is he looking to do here? Power slam off the top rope. And a kick out at one, surprising Lee. Get it, Lee? All right, I'll shut up now. All right, big clothesline by MJF, by Keith Lee to MJF. And now the punches, headbutts. Oh my gosh, just chopping all over the body. Oh, and a hurricane rana from the big man. Cover on MJF. Kick out of one. MJF gonna roll out of the ring. He's met with a roll up. And a kick out. And now going for another cover. Kick out. MJF gets right back up. Gets in the face of Keith Lee and a nice suplex and flips off Keith Lee, and Keith Lee's not gonna like that. But wait a minute! Oh! Couldn't lift him all the way to his back, so put him up front. Still adding a lot of damage. Elbows and sends him down. Cover here. And a kick out from Keith Lee at two. Oh, a big knee. And Keith Lee in a lot of trouble. Stabbed in the arm by MJF to Keith Lee. Oh, wait a minute. Crossroads! Cover! Kick out at two from Keith Lee. Now picks up, goes for a neck breaker. Oh, wait a minute, MJF up on the top rope. What could he be going for here? Elbow drop doesn't connect. Oh, it slams him down. Oh my gosh, and Keith Lee has MJF back up. Off the ropes, big elbow. And flips off the fans. Oh, and look at this. Keith Lee in a bit of trouble here with Maxwell Jacob Friedman. And Keith Lee trying to crawl over to the corner to get some fresh air, but MJF is right there. But wait a minute, it was a trap all along by Keith Lee. And watch this, double chop to both of the chest of MJF. And now, MJF going for a ride! Spirit bomb! Cover! And a kick out from MJF. And MJF fighting back here. Off the ropes. Big back elbow. Oh, it stops. And look at this. MJF. Oh, right on the back. Oh, and look at this. A submission hold from MJF trying to tap out Keith Lee. Is it going to work? Who knows? We're going to find out if Keith Lee's going to tap here tonight. And he is not. He gets out of it. And a forearm right to the face of MJF. Oh, wait a minute. Salt to the earth. Salt of the Earth is locked in. Salt of the Earth locked in on Keith Lee. Is Keith Lee going to tap right here, right now? I don't know. And a rope break. And he flips off the fans. Keith Lee. Oh, nice kick. And now Keith Lee seems pissed. Off the ropes reversal. Goes for a clothesline. Oh, he blocks it. Oh, what a pounce. And look at this. Keith Lee slams it down. And Keith Lee slams it down again. Once again, covered. Kick out once again from Keith Lee. It seemed like Keith Lee had that in control and then lost control. Oh, a big shoulder tackle. Keith Lee gonna run out the ring, but MJF is gonna follow him. And now, waiting for Keith Lee to get up and punches him straight back down. And wait a minute, Keith Lee with the elbow and sends him back into the ring. These two men having an amazing match so far. And Keith Lee, oh, wait a minute, MJF going for it. Heat seeker busting open Keith Lee. Cover here. We can't get out. Keith Lee able to kick out. Keith Lee bloody face and all. Oh, and a punch. Oh, wait a minute. Spirit bomb! Cover! And Keith Lee gets the win over MJF.
Here is your winner, Keith Lee.
Keith Lee got the win. And he did it in fashion, and now he's going to grab a microphone. Andre Graves, listen up. Time's ticking on your television championship reign, my brother. I wish nothing but love for your family. But in Chicago, opportunity for it all. United Center. I will bask in the glory while you shall fall in your glory. And everyone will know that I am limitless. Wow. Keith Lee says he is going to take the television title. Oh, wait a minute. Keith Lee says he is going to take the television title away from Andre Graves. Will that happen? We're going to find out. But our co-main event's here tonight. Will Ospreay going up against CM Punk. Will Ospreay has a date with this man, Gabriel Genocide, who's going up against Jay White. But Will Ospreay and Gabriel Genocide will meet at Opportunity for It All in Chicago for the second time for the PWE World Heavyweight Championship. And Punk here tonight looking to wear down Ospreay ahead of his match. Will Ospreay got an impressive win last week against Bryan Danielson. Can he get a win over CM Punk and Bryan Danielson? That would be big momentum for his match with Gabriel Genocide for the PWE World Championship at opportunity for it all in Chicago.
The following is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from Chicago, Illinois, weighing in at 220 pounds, CM Punk.
CM Punk has the opportunity in the match. So bear down, Will Ospreay, like I said earlier, before his match, an opportunity for it all for the World Heavyweight Championship against Xavier Genocide. Xavier Genocide could get worn down by Jay White as well. Who knows what's going to happen here tonight? All I can say is, ladies and gentlemen, be on the edge of your seats for this matchup. CM Punk, haven't seen him in a bit. He's still in BWE. Not with AEW. Champion. Will it happen? Who knows? One thing I do know is Genocide will be in the main event here tonight. We'll see. Ospreay had some words for Genocide last week, or last episode. If he has some words for him this episode. There is Ospreay, there is Punk. Oh, backflip on another one. And a clothesline sending CM Punk out of the ring. And Punk not gonna like that. Comes back into the ring. Oh, Punk blocks. And now, Ospreay on the offensive. Oh no, clothesline. What is Ospreay looking to do? Ospreay off the ropes. Oh my gosh. What a move from Will Ospreay to Punk. Oh my God, and just sending him into the barricade.
Three.
And no remorse from Will Ospreay to Punk.
Four.
Punk is just getting butchered right now.
Five.
Oh, and a headbutt. But he's not done. Count of eight. Is Will Ospreay looking to get a count out victory here? Count of nine. Punk. Hey, Will Ospreay. Punk walks out.
Here is your winner, Will Oxley.
Will Ospreay got the win here tonight with a count out victory. And you can see Punk looking defeated on the outside. Will Ospreay getting the count out victory here tonight. It's what you hate to see. Hopefully there's not a count out here in this match, as the man that will be facing Will Ospreay, Gabriel Genocide, goes one-on-one with Jay White here tonight. Wow, I can't believe Will Ospreay took a count-out victory. Actually, I can believe it, knowing Will Ospreay.
The following is scheduled for 1-4, making his way to the ring from Louisville, Kentucky, weighing in at 235 pounds, the World Heavyweight Champion, Gabriel Cole.
Gabriel Genocide here tonight. After just seeing what happened with Will Ospreay and CM Punk, now he steps in the ring with Jay White in our main event. We are going to see if Gabriel Genocide can get the win here tonight. Here comes the switchblade.
And his opponent from Auckland, New Zealand, weighing in at 220 pounds, Jay White.
Jay White has the opportunity to wear down Gabriel Genocide ahead of opportunity for it all, giving Will Ospreay the advantage for the PWE World Heavyweight Championship. It is possible, but Jay White has to dig deep down inside if he wants to go ahead and knock off Gabriel Genocide here tonight. We're gonna see that match right now. There is Genocide. There is Jay White. Genocide, Jay White, main event. The last match before PWE Opportunity for All. And these two men going at it, toe to toe. Oh, and look at this. And a super kick. By Genocide. And Genocide with a knee. Oh, and a big boot. But a shortened version. We know the longer version from Genocide if you've been watching Genocide for a long time. Big super kick. And an uppercut to Jay White. The cover here on Jay. Kick out of two from Jay White. Going for another cover. Kick out from Jay White. And another one. And Jay White's gonna kick out of that. Oh, wait a minute. Jay White has him up. Slams him down. But Jay White not going for the cover. What's he gonna do? Oh no! Blade Runner! The Genocide! Cover! Oh, and a kick out! That was close. That was close to the end. For Genocide, oh, and a counter. Bluegrass kick. Cover. And a kick out from Jay White. These two men already putting their bodies on the line in this contest. Jay White counters. Springboard super kick busted open. Jay White cover. And a kick out from Jay White. And a clothesline. Cover here. And a kick out once again from Jay White. And Jay White once again going for that suplex. He hits it. This time goes for the cover. Oh, and a kick out from Gabriel Genocide. Oh no, Jay White's gonna pick him up. And a Blade Runner once again. Cover here on Genocide. Kick out once again. Genocide on a whole nother level. And Genocide, the East River Dells. Cover. Oh, and a kick out. And he can't believe it. He's going for the pin once again. Can't believe what just happened. And a kick out again. Oh, wait a minute. Submission hold locked in. Genocide could tap easily right here. But he's not going to. Rolls over. Punches him. Trying to relieve pressure off the knee. Holding the knee tight. It's not the exposed knee, however. So, Genocide. Oh. Oh, and look at that. Look at that sequence. Oh, and a kick out. Big kick. Cover. And a kick out from Jay White. The Genocide sends him down again. And a kick out at one. Oh, wait a minute. Genocide got out of the way. It looked like Jay White was going for something. Slams him down. Oh, and look at this. Jay White playing mind games. Oh, no, 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 no! Stomp on the arm. Damn it, Jay. And goes for the suplex once again. Cover on Genocide. Kick out of two. He's still in it. Blade Runner for the third time. No way. Genocide kicks out of this. Oh, and it does. Genocide still alive. Oh, punch to the gut. It's River Dells. Cover. And Genocide gets the win here tonight.
Here is your winner, Gabriel Cole.
And now, Genocide grabbing the mic. Will Ospreay, you said you're gonna piss on my grave. An opportunity for it all in Chicago. Based off how you just won that match and a count out victory, you don't look like you can piss on anyone's grave. Yeah, you beat Punk. Yeah, you beat Danielson, but you haven't beaten me. You didn't beat me in Nashville, and you ain't gonna beat me in Chicago. I am going to walk out of Opportunity for It All. Still, PWE's World Heavyweight Champion, because I care about these fans, unlike you. You piece of shit. Oh, and look at Genocide. Genocide sending strong words to Will Ospreay ahead of Opportunity for It All. Ladies and gentlemen, that is the end of our episode here tonight. And now we can finally move on to Opportunity for It All. It's going to happen. Ladies and gentlemen, we hope you enjoyed, and we will see you in the next episode. Good night, everybody.